My name is Marieke Oudelaar, and since October 2020, I'm a research group leader at the Max Planck Institute for Biophysical Chemistry, and our group is funded by the Lise Meitner program of the Max Planck Society. Our group is called the Genome Organization and Regulation Group, and our aim is to better understand how our genome or how our DNA works and how it instructs the functioning of our cells. Complex organisms have hundreds of different cell types. So we have skin cells, brain cells, liver cells, and each of these different cells has a very different function, even though every cell in a single individual has the exact same DNA code. And so the development of multiple cell types in complex organisms is only possible because different cells can activate different parts of their DNA, or they regulate the expression of their genes, as we call it. And we are really interested in the fundamental principles by which gene expression is regulated. And in particular, we are interested in the relationship between the activity of the DNA and the three-dimensional structure of the DNA inside the cell. So cells actually contain a lot of DNA. So if you stretch out the DNA molecules inside a cell, they span about 2 meters, but somehow they are able to fit within a cell that is smaller than the diameter of your hair. So that means that the DNA is really compacted and folded, and the resulting three-dimensional DNA structures are related to the activity of the DNA in the cell. And so what we're trying to do is to understand exactly what kind of structures are formed and what molecular mechanisms are responsible for the formation of these structures, and how these structures then relate to the activity of the DNA. I find this a really interesting and important research area because I think the regulation of gene expression is really a very fundamental process in biology, and it's also relevant for many diseases to better understand how our genome works. We know that DNA mutations cause cancer and that genetic variation between people can predispose them to certain diseases. But for the vast majority of these genetic changes, we do not understand the mechanisms, and we are not able to use this information for the development of therapies. So the methods that we use in our research are chromosome conformation capture, or 3C methods. And what we do in these approaches is that we chemically fix cells, and we then cut the fixed DNA structures in these cells in very small pieces. And we then paste these pieces back together in a way that the bits of DNA that were closed in three-dimensional space are now linked together. So essentially, we reorder the linear DNA sequence into a sequence that reflects the three-dimensional structure in the cell. We can then sequence this reordered DNA string, and we can do computational analyses to derive matrices of contact points in the DNA sequence and reconstruct three-dimensional structures. The concept behind 3C has been developed about 2 decades ago, and we have further developed these approaches to allow for analyses of three-dimensional DNA structures in more detail. And we're using these approaches in combination with analyses of the activity of DNA sequences to understand exactly how these processes relate to each other during the development of specialized cell types. So in the future, we would also really like to integrate different approaches to study the three-dimensional DNA structure inside the cell. And in particular, we're really interested to integrate imaging approaches, in particular super-resolution microscopy and live cell imaging. And there are a lot of recent exciting developments in this field. This is also what makes this institute a really good place for us to be, because there are really great facilities and great colleagues to collaborate with that enable us to integrate different methods and approach biological challenges from different angles.